even the very worst difficulties. One of the clearest examples of this is his words when he was hiding in a cave with Abu Bakr after leaving Mecca. Our Prophet's words are related as follows in the Quran. If you do not help him, God did help him when those who did not believe drove him out, and there were two of them in the cave. He said to his companion, "Do not be despondent, God is with us." Then God sent down his serenity upon him, and reinforced him with troops you could not see. He made the word of those who did not believe undermost. It is the word of God which is uppermost. God is almighty, all-wise. The Prophet's words and actions are the best possible models for believers. Because interpreting events auspiciously is an important virtue stemming from sincere faith in God and a way of life imposed by that faith. Believers face up to everything that befalls them with great maturity and know that there is a reason for these events. They first do all they can to resolve a matter. They then place their trust in God and accept the outcome and try to see its auspicious aspect. In one hadith, our Prophet described the reward that those who put their trust in God can expect. If you put your faith completely in God, He will arrange for your sustenance in the same way as He provides for the bird. They go out in the morning with their stomachs empty and return filled in the evening. There were people with varying characters and ideas that surrounded the Prophet. Throughout his life, however, he showed an interest in each and every one, warned them about their mistakes and failings, and tried to educate them in all matters, from cleanliness to matters of faith. That compassionate, tolerant, understanding, and patient attitude of his was the means by which many people's hearts were warmed to Islam and developed a genuine love for the Prophet. God describes this pleasing attitude adopted by the Prophet towards those around him in the Quran. It is a mercy from God that you were gentle with them. If you had been rough or hard of heart, they would have scattered from around you. So pardon them and ask forgiveness for them. The Prophet never pressured those around him to accept the religion, nor imposed conditions on them. Instead, he always used the pleasantest means to tell them about it. Imam Ghazali, the great Islamic scholar, summed up the Prophet's treatment of those around him in light of the information found in the hadith. Everyone thought that the Prophet honored him more. Whoever came to him could see his face. He used to call his companions by their surnames with honor, and he used to give a surname to anyone who had no surname. He was very affectionate and kind in dealing with the people. Be upholders of justice, bearing witness for God alone, even against yourselves or your parents and relatives. Whether they are rich or poor, God is well able to look after them. Do not follow your own desires and deviate from the truth. Prophet Muhammad lived in a place where people of different religions, languages, races, and tribes all coexisted. It was very difficult for those societies to live together in peace and security. Yet the justice of the Prophet was a source of peace and security for other communities living in the Arabian Peninsula, just as much as it was for Muslims. During the time of the Prophet, Christians, Jews, and pagans were all treated equally. The Prophet explained the true religion to everyone, but left them free to make up their own minds, because God's commandment was crystal clear and absolute. There is no compulsion where the religion is concerned. In other verses, God reveals, "So remind them, you are only a reminder, you are not in control of them." The Constitution of Medina, signed by the Muslim immigrants from Mecca, the indigenous Muslims of Medina, and the Jews of Medina, is another important example of justice. The aim of this treaty was to ensure justice among communities holding different beliefs to found a common order. One of the most outstanding features of the treaty is the freedom of belief it established. One of the articles in it reads, "The Jews of Banu Auf are one nation with the Muslims. The Jews have their religion, and the Muslims have theirs." In our day, the only solution to the fighting and conflict going on all over the world is to adopt the morality of the Quran and, like the Prophet, never to depart from the path of justice, making no distinction between different religions, languages, or races. Because only in that way can humanity attain the peace, security, and happiness it needs. And peace, security, and justice prevail all over the world, just as in the time of our Prophet. Our Prophet was a protector and administrator for believers. Muslims, therefore, referred to him in all matters and sought his permission and opinion before engaging in anything. When they disagreed among themselves or were unable to resolve an issue, they immediately communicated this to the Prophet and implemented the most auspicious and reliable solution by learning it from him. Because they knew that he was the most intelligent of the community. His commands and judgments were under the protection of God. His decisions were therefore always the most auspicious. Our Prophet Muhammad, a chosen individual, is a role model in our time, and his sunnah is an important guide for all humanity. Therefore, obedience to him is the true path to salvation, both in this world and the eternal life of the hereafter. It is revealed in the Quran that those who obey the Prophet are actually obeying God. Those who rebel against him, on the other hand, actually rebel against God. Whoever obeys the Messenger has obeyed God. If anyone turns away, we did not send you to them as their keeper.